Very good day to all of you. A warm welcome to all the students of the orientation program for the Children's Science Congress that is to be conducted by Dr. K.C. Narayan. He is the National Coordinator for Children's Science Congress. Let me take this opportunity to welcome the CIF officials. And before I start anything, I would like to read out the profile of Dr. Narayan, the facilitator. I also would like to welcome the teachers and the guides present here with the children. A brief profile of Dr. Narayan and the facilitator. Mr. Narayan is a PhD chemistry from UDCT, now ICT Mumbai. 28 years of experience in the industry. Various senior positions in R&D and quality assurance in the field of surfactants, detergents, cosmetics, enzymes, and paints. Currently lead scientist in SABIC. He has been working there. Active in Toastmasters, one of the organizers in SATAC, Saudi Arabian Annual Toastmasters Conference, National Conference. This was just briefly what I had to speak about his, but I'm of the firm belief that it doesn't matter how long you lived, but it does matter when you say what you have contributed to society. And that goes very well with Dr. Narayan. Dr. Narayan has been the best catalyst who worked towards giving another dimension to Science India Forum KSC. He has made up the challenging, he has taken up the challenging, challenges of pioneering the Children's Science Congress in this country. You require a mindset of selfless dedication if you have to achieve goals. And this is what Dr. Narayan is, a driving force, a promoter, a mediator, an organizer, all in one. Here he is to kindle the scientific temperaments in you students. Take the best of what you can today and you will understand what you have gained. What he's going to give you today is an insight into what is the Children's Science Congress. So sit back and listen carefully to what Dr. Narayan has to say. Sir.
Thank you very much, Padma teacher. I welcome all the students and teachers to this orientation. We had one orientation for the school teachers and then some of them could not attend. So I welcome all the others who are attending this. And then also maybe some of them wanted to attend again. Some of the schools, students are familiar with the Children's Science Congress because some of you participated in the last year Children's Science Congress. Children's Science Congress is organized by Government of India with the initiative from Department of Science and Technology and National Council for Science, Technology and Communication, which is also part of the Government of India. So this was started in the year 1993. Let me first share the screen. This was started in the year 1993, and the last year was the 27th Children's Science Congress, National Children's Science Congress, which was organized in the capital of Kerala, which is Trivandrum. This is a 5 days program. Every year it happens from December 27th to 31st. And normally it is organized in the different states of India. This year it was supposed to be organized in Chandigarh, but unfortunately due to the COVID-19, it has been called off. However, Saudi Arabia will go ahead with the Children's Science Congress at the national level in Saudi Arabia. So what happens in this is the children, So the Government of India gives a theme and then a few sub-themes based out of that. And normally this is for 2 years. So we'll see what is the theme for this year. And the children go through the one activity guide is also given for the children to understand exactly what is this program about and then how are they supposed to prepare the project. So Children's Science Congress is the only competition which is a research-based competition, which takes place in India. So the children are given an opportunity to think creatively and then come up with solutions or approaches to the day-to-day problems which we see in the society, which come across the society, in our surroundings, basically. So the children register themselves and then prepare on the project. They pick up on some problem which is based out of which they see in the day-to-day life, and then try to come up with some solution at their level, not a high level. So the children are supposed to think only at their level. The expectation is only also so much. And then the children prepare a report and submit to the school, and they will be assigned one guide, which is normally a school teacher, and then also one of the students is a leader, and there is one team member who will also work with the team leader. Once this is submitted, then the children, the school normally conducts a competition, and then the winners are selected from the school, and then they go to the district level in India, and the winners from the district level go to the state level, and the winners from the state level, from all the states, they come to the national level, which is organized between December 27 to 31st. So Saudi Arabia is considered as one of the states. So last year was the first year in which the Science India Forum organized the Children Science Congress for the first time ever in the history. And there were a few students who were lucky to participate at the national level. And I was also a part of them. I traveled along with them. And I was fortunate to be part of them and witness exactly what happens there. So I'll take you through the details of the orientation. Before that, let's just go through the highlights of last year's National Children Science Congress during our visit in Trivandrum. So this is the glimpses of Children Science Congress, which was held at Trivandrum from December 27 to 31st, 2019. So normally the program looks like this. The children arrive on 26th of December, and then they do the registration, and then they are given some kit, which will have a bag with the...
Okay, not sir. Sir, 1 minute. Are you sharing the screen?
Yes.
Can you children see this sharing the screen? Are you able to see?
Let me check whether share screen is open. Okay, I think it was not on.
Yes.
Are you able to see the screen now? Okay, now it's on. So this is how the program looks like. So the children register on the 26th of December, and then they are given a kit along with the program, and then also a few other items which is required for them to be participating in the program. And then it starts with a procession of all the state-wise. It goes from one after the other, and then they all proceed to the flag hoisting and oath ceremony, and then the inauguration takes place, and then there is a program called Meet the Scientist. I will explain to you what is this Meet the Scientist program in the following slides. And then we have there is an oral presentation for these students who participate in the at the national level, and then there is also parallel poster session and activity corner where you have exhibitions, and then there is cultural evening on all these 5 days, and then also teachers workshop for the teachers who accompany the participants, and there is a techno tour to the nearby one of the biggest science research center, and then there is a validity function where the children are recognized with their certificates as well as the achievements. So this is the process.
समाज तथा देशस्य हिताय कार्यरत भविष्यामि जय विज्ञान. Now we repeat in English. We the child scientists on this auspicious occasion take an oath that we would create a clean, green, and healthy nation.
So that was the oath ceremony in which the children are asked to go through the theme, which is the clean, green and healthy nation the last year. And then followed by that is the inauguration where the eminent personalities from India come and do the inauguration of this event. As you can see, the Kerala Chief Minister is sitting and then Shashi Tharoor is sitting. So eminent personalities address the ceremony during the inauguration. These are the three children who participated in the last year at the national level, the winners from Saudi Arabia. All of them are female. There was one boy who could not participate. And then in the afternoon, so after this, everyone disperses for lunch, and there is a very nice lunch organized at the venue. The coupons are given for each day lunch, breakfast, and then dinner. So, and then there is a Meet Scientist program where eminent scientists from India come and give various speech on various topics. So this is one, which is science and technology developments in aerospace. And then children are asked to ask questions, and the best top three questions are given prizes. So these are the children from Saudi Arabia, Riyadh, who got award on the Meet Scientist program. This is just a motivation for the children. So the children get an opportunity to interact with the eminent scientist. And then followed by that, the oral presentation starts. And then this is how the oral presentation is conducted. So you can see that there is one person sitting with a computer who calls the name of the student. And then the judges are sitting in front of the children. And then on the left side, you can see that our children are sitting ready, getting ready for their turn to come. And then the students who give the oral presentation, they start giving their poster presentation the next day morning. So whoever gives in the afternoon, they can give their poster presentation in the morning. And then whoever gives in the morning session, they start give their poster presentation in the afternoon. So this is how it is organized. So there are various, many schools or participants who give to, are assembled here. So in one row, there are about 10 students who poster, do the poster presentation. Each of them are given given a space for four posters. So this is how so this is open for this is open for the public. Everybody can attend. So this is one of the project from Kashmir. I was very much impressed with this, so I just took the details of this girl, and then this girl actually came in the top 18 projects, which was which were about 19 projects which were identified as the promising projects, and they are given opportunity to implement their project with the support of the Government of India. The Government of India gives the financial support for them to implement their project. I'll explain to you what is this project about in the following slides. And so this is our student who participated there, Prashantini. This is also one of our students who's giving explanation to the visitors. And this student also got selected in the top 19 projects. She's from Assam. I'll explain about this project also. Yeah, this is the project. So this is indigenously prepared natural food color. So what she has done is she took up some flowers like the rose as well as the night jasmine, and then she extracted with water, and then the color was she took the color and then made it as a dry powder, and then applied it on rice as well as some sweets, and then gave. So this is something like an old what you call traditional system which Indians used to follow in Assam, but then unfortunately maybe it is stopped, and then she tried to understand it technically, how is it scientifically, how does it help, and then also she gave prepared a report and then gave the submitted the report with the help of what all benefits it gives in terms of the nutrients, and also how can it be done, and then how will it benefit people if they consume. This is another project which is safe disposal of sanitary napkin. So this girl actually also came in the top 19. So she prepared one Mensa burner, so that this is to burn the sanitary napkins locally, So what happens is normally a lot of sanitary napkins get collected and then it contributes to a lot of pollution. Therefore, she came up with a small, simple process where she took a tin container in which she places an earthen pot with a mesh, and then the sanitary napkin is kept inside, and then she heats it with the help of an electrical burner. And then within 3 minutes, it becomes ash, and then through the mesh, it comes down, which can be used as a fertilizer by mixing some other ingredients. And the gas she passes through, oxidizing agent as well as a reducing agent like ferrous sulfate as well as potassium bichromate, so that non-toxic gas gets evolved. That is a wonderful concept. And then these are some more projects which you can see. Studies. Teacher, can you please admit these people who are coming in the waiting room? It is disturbing me.
I'm admitting, sir, seeing who is admitted, because I removed two children out of the room because of behavior.
Okay. Because it is coming and appearing on screen. And so this is another project, and then you can see here. Okay, so precious money plant. So from money plant, what can be done? So this is another project on which one team worked on. And then, so this is the hypothesis and the need continuity of that project. And then these are the items which the children made out of the money plant, from the fiber of money plant. And this is spoons which you can eat. So this team worked with some grain, like, and then made spoons out of this. So after, while eating the food, you can also eat the spoon so that you don't dispose it as a plastic spoon. The student who was giving a presentation during post presentation, Kripa Matthew from Alias International School. Parallelly, teachers' workshop also happens. So, teachers who travel along with the participants can enrich their knowledge by attending these workshops. And then there are cultural evenings, the evening on every day, where various cultural events, it's really worth watching them. Wonderful cultural evenings of various cultures. And then we were taken to ISRO. So we are on the way. This is the Middle East team. We're on the way to ISRO. Unfortunately, we were not allowed to carry our mobile phones inside, so we could not take any photographs there. And then in the validatory function, the recognition is given to the participants. This is one of the students who got A grade from Riyadh, from Alias International School, Krishnendu Hashir. So this is the medal that is given to the students who participate. They're also given certificates. So let me go back and then open this certificate and show it to you. So this is how the certificate looks like. So you can see the Government of India seal, stamp. And then December 27th to 31st, 27th National Children's Congress. And then the project title is given here, Eye Health, an Imperative Step Towards a Healthy Vision for Life. And then the participants' names are given, Krishnendu Hashir and Avantika Jayakrishnan, Alias International School. The guide's name is also given. And then the assessment is also there. So these are the criteria, originality of idea and concept, relevance to the project and of the project and to the team. Understanding of the issue, data collection, experimentation, validation, and interpretation. And then oral presentation, how was it? And then also overall grade A. So the first attempt itself, Saudi Arabia got A grade, which is one of the rare cases in the Middle East. This was the only team which got A grade, which is a big achievement. Then you can see that the chairman of National Academic Committee and the chief coordinator of NCC have signed this. And then Vice President of India, Venkaiah Naidu, graced the occasion with his presence. And then you can see on the right side that he is interacting with the students. So this was also one of the experiences for the children there. This was the GCC team from all the Gulf countries. So just a group photo just for memory was taken. All the participating students, teachers, and the accompanying teachers, as well as the science and forum coordinators. Not only that, when the children return and the certificates, the the schools proudly felicitate the students in their school, respective schools, by presenting the certificate. Now, before moving to the orientation, let's try to understand more about what is the National Children's Science Congress about. As I mentioned, this was started in the year 1993 to promote a new generation of creative scientists. And this is organized by NCSTC and DST, as I mentioned at the beginning. And in the Middle East, Science India Forum is the official authority to conduct the Children's Science Congress, of course, in association with all the schools. Let's look at the objectives. So what are the objectives? To make a forum available for the children of the age group 10 to 17. Give opportunity to exhibit their creativity and innovativeness through, by think of some, taking up some problem which we see in the society on a day-to-day basis, ponder about what could be the reason for those problems, and then use scientific process to solve the problem. I'll explain to you what is the scientific problem later on, scientific process, and then also closely observe, and then build models on this, and then experiments and field work. And then encourages a sense of discovery. So the idea is basically to give the children a sense of creativity and innovativeness. So we all see various types of problems in our day-to-day life. Like, I can give a small example. So every day when I come out of my house, I see garbage bins, one in black color and one in green color. I'm sure all of you would have seen this. And about a year ago, Saudi Arabia started this. But if you look at, no orientation was given to the houses as to what exactly is the purpose of this and what are the householders supposed to do. Like, one of them is actually for disposing the garbage which are organic in nature. The others are for the ones which are inorganic in nature. But then unfortunately, what I see is that people go and dump anything in any. So there is no segregation that happens. Like, so this is one of the problems I'm just giving as an example. I mean, is it possible to come up with a solution for this? Of course. We have to only think about this. So there are many problems which we come as soon as we get out of our house. We see many problems. It could be locally here or it could be in India. So you can think about some of the problems which are relevant to the focal theme and the sub-themes which we will see here. So encourage the children to express their views. So these are the objectives. So this year's theme, not only for this year, it's also for this year plus next year, that is Science for Sustainable Living. So sustainability is has got three basic elements, natural environment, economic viability, and then healthy communities. It consists of these. Let's look at the objectives of this focal theme. Motivate and encourage, engage the children for inquiry-based learning exercise to learn ecology, economy, society, and their interrelationships. To apply scientific understanding in the day-to-day decision making, as I mentioned, we'll see how to go about the scientific process to have an understanding. To design and develop approach solution for tapping potentiality and overcoming the gaps and challenges. So pay attention here. So it says that you don't have to give solution even if you have a good approach to a problem, to solve a problem, that's also is enough. So to design and develop either approach or solution for tapping potentiality and overcoming the gaps and challenges for the problems which you come across on a day-to-day basis. To take initiatives for personal reflection and transformation to community and society. So here, what it says is that there could be some solutions available for some of them. Then you can reflect it personally, and then based on your reflection, you might come up with some other solution for the problem. Although there may be something which is existing. So you can definitely come up with those as your creative ideas to give either an approach or solution to the problem. Now let's look at what are the sub-themes for under these themes. So the first one is ecosystem for sustainable living. The second theme is appropriate technology for sustainable living. We'll go through all these sub-themes in detail in the following slides. Social innovation for sustainable living. Design, development, modeling, and planning for sustainable living, and traditional knowledge system for sustainable living. Now, before getting into the detail of the sub-themes, let's look at what are the four pillars of the the Children's Science Congress project. Unless you understand this very clearly, you will not be able to pick up the right problem and then start working on it. So the most important, the first and most important criteria is that it should be very simple. Do not pick up something which is very, which is above the children level. So one of the important feedback or the key feedback which we got last year when we went to represent Saudi Arabia at the national level was that most of the, or almost all projects, excepting a few projects, were of a high profile. So there was one of the problems was pyrolysis of plastic waste. So we have to pick up some solution approach in such a way that you will not spend a lot of money. Like most of the problems which got into, which were selected as the promising projects, will be implemented and Department of Science and Technology will financially support. So they should be in the range of what, 1 lakh to 2 lakh Indian rupees, or maximum maybe 3 lakhs or so. So it will come to be about 5,000 to 10,000 riyals. So when you talk about pyrolysis, it will cost thousands and thousands of, hundred thousands of riyals. So do not go for such kind of problems. It should be practical. That means we should be able to practically implement, which means it should be, and then it should be innovative. Innovative doesn't mean that it should be innovative globally. It can be innovative in the problem which you are addressing to. So it may be available, but then for the problem which you are attending to, it may be innovative. And then inexpensive, as I said, do not go to a problem which will cost more than 5,000 to 10,000 or maximum 20,000 riyals, or not even 20,000 riyals, 10,000 would be appropriate. And then let me also share what were the promising projects. Out of 1,200 projects which students represented at the national level in Trivandrum, only 19 projects got selected. So this is one indigenously prepared natural food color, which I showed you as one girl worked with rose extract as well as the jasmine, night jasmine extract from Assam. She got selected. And then evaporative food storage box. This is from Kendriya Vidyalaya. Kendriya Vidyalaya is they form their own group. They do not belong to any states in India. So they are given a separate group. So they represent as KV Sangathe. Use of acacia. So this is one of the bioextract as a mosquito larvicide and sewage treatment agent. This is from West Bengal. Analysis of stress among students. See, this is a social related problem. Like it's not a typically science related problem. So what is causing stress among students? So one study was done by one girl, boy from Aryan from Maharashtra. And then he came up with some ideas, creative, at his level. So not a very high profile level. Get rid of Vazwan plastic by using some orchid. This is the Jammu Kashmir girl whom I showed in the beginning slide, Asiya Ashraf. So what it is, the Kashmiris, so Vazwan plastic means the plastic which comes out as waste during our celebrations, or during like, it could be wedding or any other big occasion. Samarklin is a kettle which they use for preparing their kawa, you know, the tea, Kashmiri tea, which is called kawa. So it has got two chambers. One is an external chamber and one is an internal, the other one is an internal chamber. The internal chamber, they put the coal and then they heat it. And then the external chamber has got the their extract, which comes out as the kawa. So she made something similar with a little bit of modification, and then she took the coal inside, and then outside she put all these plastic bottles, like the water bottle or some small cups which we use in the marriage and all, and then it gets melted and then comes out as a liquid. Then it is collected as a liquid plastic which can be used to form tiles. And the toxic gas she passed through a liquid to absorb all the gases so that the toxic gas doesn't come out. A wonderful concept, instead of collecting all the garbages and then going and throwing, which will occupy a lot of volume, she came up with an amazing idea of solving the garbage, the waste which comes out during our big celebrations. And then a study on the uses of and formulations practical practices, the medicinal plant by the indigenous people of Kolarian. This is from Arunachal Pradesh. Possibility of using waste fish scale in removing iron and hardness. This is from Kerala, a girl called Bhadra. Study of making inks for ink pens using natural dyes. So that is again eco-friendly solution. Lightweight paper by Rana Technology. Safe disposal of sanitary napkin, menso burner, which I explained at the beginning. This girl is Kritika Singh from Punjab. And then innovative device for hearing. These are all simple solutions. Study on seed germination using earthen pot irrigation. Ancient tips to breathe well. So this is something related to yoga. So there are many things which used to be practiced by our ancestors, but then most of us did not know the scientific reason, and therefore we have discontinued all of them. So you can check with your grandparents and then what were they following, and then also you can do some survey and then try to find out who is doing what, and then try to find to Google and then find out if anything is available regarding, and then try to find out the scientific reason, and then is it possible to add your own creativity to it and then come up with a solution. So it's a very, very simple problem which we normally we come across on a day-to-day basis. The remedial study to be children suffering from cerebral palsy with the analysis of its causes, diagnosis and treatment. This is from Gujarat. Spraying pesticide, collecting and removing weeds, transforming of fertilizer. Determination of carbon sequestration ability of landscaping tree species. A comparative study on horicha. This is a food preparation in Assam. So this girl has studied, Swastika, she has studied by taking different bamboo shoots, different type of bamboo shoots, and then try to compare and then come up with a report where it says that some of them do not contribute much to the taste, and then some of them do not even give nutrients. So which one is the best? And then which one contributes the best to the taste. And then Arika Mag, this betel nut. So how can we make ink out of betel nut instead of producing it synthetically? An innovative project for the betterment of the environment. This girl is from Karnataka. So the first is ecosystem for sustainable living. Let's look at what are the coverages under this. So learning about ecosystem components, their functions and interrelations. So this is talking about learnings. See, so you don't need to be actually doing an experiment and then trying to. So try to understand what are the interrelations between ecosystem components. Like ecosystem components are basically the plants, and then also something which produces for the consumers to eat, right? And then the bacteria and then other things which contribute to the decomposition of this. So these are the components, and then how are they interrelated? And then there are abiotic components, so like water, air, soil, etc., which also contribute, temperature, etc., which contributes to this decomposition or the existence of this biotic system itself. So learn about that and then try to contribute some creativity from your side. Exploring diversity of life. So we all of us experience various kinds of biodiversity problem due to the civilization and the modern civilization, also the developments that is happening mainly in the cities and also even at the other places. How do they contribute to the ecology, economy and also social sustainability? And then natural resource management to this. Impact of human activities, which is again something which is related to the behaviors, like how do we generate the waste, also the civilization, etc. And the conservation of biodiversity and the ecosystem. So there are so many problems which, if you just think, you will be able to come up with various biodiversity related problems which are relevant to the ecosystem on a day-to-day basis. Ecosystem approach for sustainable living. So they're all, most of them are interrelated. So try to pick up something which you come across on a day-to-day basis. Let's look at one of the problems. A systematic study of different fruit-bearing plants in a homestead garden. So most of us have a homestead garden in India. So how does it, so this is a systematic study on this. So how is this done? So plants are one of the essential components for ecosystem. As I mentioned in the previous slide, so the plants give us food, right? They are one which can directly store energy from sunlight and convert them into food, and then we survive on this. So the objective is to understand the role of homestead gardens in sustainable living and then to study the best practices of homestead gardens. So the methodology is measure the area of your homestead garden. So you can interview various people who have a homestead garden and try to ask them these questions as to how much area do they have, and then identify what kind of plant species they have. And then interview the owner. Not only the owner, you can also interview the gardener as well as the homestead of the homestead garden. And then assess what kind of nutrient the fruits that are harvested, what kind of nutrients do they give, and then what are the calorific values. You can also consult any agriculturist or nutritionist to get more information about these. And then economy of the fruits harvested, different types of tools that they use, like propagation, sowing, or planting. How do they do? Do they use organic or inorganic fertilizers? And then the source of fertilizers, where is it coming from? And also periodicity. So this gives an helps the students to understand the ecosystem services of homestead gardens, and how is it contributing to the livelihood of and sustenance of a family. Let's look at the next problem. So this is appropriate technology. This is the second sub-theme: appropriate technology for sustainable living. So as I mentioned to you in the beginning, there are many technologies which our ancestors used to use, but then most of them we do not even know that they are still existing in practice. So we'll go through some of the examples after going through this. What are the coverage? What do they cover? Design and develop appropriate technology. It could be some simple solutions which could have already been used by our ancestors, but then we do not know what are the scientific reasons behind them. So try to identify them and then give your own a little bit of creativity to it, and then make it as a project. Ecosystem management, ecosystem-based production, responsible consumption. Are we responsible enough? How do we in the consumption? Like in Saudi Arabia, I can give one of the examples in the cities, not only in Saudi Arabia. There are a lot of packaged foods which come, like processed food, which are not healthy for us to be consuming. Natural food is always healthy. So we can definitely study, make a scientific study out of this, and then try to come up with some creative solution for this at your children's level. Sustainable habitat development, management of human-wildlife conflict. So wildlife conflict, human-wildlife conflict, this is because as we civilize, as we develop, advance, and then develop our cities, wildlife slowly gets extinguished, right? So there is a conflict. So how can we address this? Is there a way by which we can address this to come up with some solutions or approaches? Harnessing renewable energy, achieving energy efficiency, etc. So let's look at one of the solutions. So this is drying of fruits. In order to make food available in off-season, it needs to be preserved. Fish, meat, vegetables, fruits, herbs, etc. have been dried to preserve. Like we all eat dry fruits. So this project tries to understand the dynamics of drying process. So what are the objectives? To understand the dynamics of preservation of food. So how does the food get preserved by drying? So the methodology is food products, take a tray, thermometer, weighing scale, and then do the experimentation by select the material, prepare a tray. It could be metal, bamboo, or wood, whatever it may be. So you can compare by drying between these various substrates in which it can be dried, and then keep the material in the tray, and then measure the temperature, and then dry them at various conditions. Like one could be directly under the sun, the other one could be in a hot condition but not under the sun. The other one could be artificial in an oven, and then you try to draw a graph between time versus temperature versus the humidity, because each one will have different humidity conditions, and then observe and then give some explanation and then give some suggestions to improve the performance. Let's look at one more project: wastewater treatment using reed beds. So this is a home-based solution. Water is becoming scarce day by day, right? Hence, there is a need to conserve, recycle, and reuse water to reduce freshwater consumption in households. So how can we recycle and reuse the wastewater that is coming out of a home. To assess the efficiency of biological treatment system in treating household gray water. So one of the students last year, Prashanthini, had worked on a similar product to make use of gray water directly using it for plants instead of using a fresh water. So you save energy by doing that. So this is something, but then this is a treatment basically, but then a home-based solution for treatment. So the materials required are drum, tub, pebbles, pH strips, and then test tubes, chemicals, cow dung, slurry, etc. So how is this done? The experimentation says that take a used tub and then make a suitable inlets and outlets. So do not go and buy a new one, because then if you buy plastic, then again you are contributing to the ecosystem, giving a problem to the ecosystem. Fill the tub with pebbles up to 75% of its capacity. Collect gray water from the household in a suitable container. Assess the quality of water. So, and then fill a non-quantity of gray water in the tub and then allow it to remain for 7 days. And then after 4 days, assess the quality. And then measure it after every 3 days. Repeat this 3 times. Repeat the steps, that is the quality of water. After adding cow dung, which will act as a fertilizer, and then any microorganism to treat the water to make it a good quality, and then grow aquatic plants over the same. And then, so the cow dung will act as a nutrient to the plant, and then observe the change in parameters of the water quality by analysis. So whatever water comes out of this, how is it? And then try to come up. So what's the outcome of this? Understand the efficiency of different biological treatment systems and understand the scientific principles involved in water quality monitoring. Now, this is a new, so far till last year, all the projects used to be science-based. That is why this itself is called as science projects or children science projects. But this year, the government has come up with a new sub-theme, which is social, so social issues for waste. So as you can see in the bottom three pictures, the first one is the students are carrying some waste in the plastic bags, right? So this is one of the problem which was faced in Assam. Nearby a school, all the residents used to burn their plastics in their outside their house in the open land, and then it used to produce a lot of pollution, and then the schools faced serious problem with it. So they started pondering and then discussing, and then they came up with this innovative idea. Instead of collecting fees from the students, they said, children, all of them, if they bring their home waste in a plastic bag, they will all be free from their school fees, so they don't have to pay fee. So all the residents nearby the school, all of them stopped burning their waste. So none of the plastic got waste burnt. So automatically the problem of the burning plastic got, or even the other waste which produces a lot of pollution, got automatically eliminated. The second picture, you can see that there is a Padman and a real Padman. So real Padman, most of you would have seen the picture named Padman. Akshay Kumar has acted in that. And then the real Padman is Arunachalam from Tamil Nadu. He came up with a very, very economical, cheap sanitary napkin. But the main problem was not that. One is to manufacture something which is very economical, which the common man can afford to. The main problem which he faced was because of the cultural taboos associated in our, which we face in India, the women were not ready to even use it because they all felt that they can't do it because of the cultural issues, you know. So convincing them to start using this was one of the biggest challenges which he faced, but then he became successful when he kept on working on it with the help of many females. And the third one, you can see that this is Swachh Bharat mission, which our Prime Minister Narendra Modi started. And then it is working out really well. And then a lot of improvements have happened in many cities, although India is a huge have got many issues, so it will not be visible in many places, but then there are many places where it is working out really well. So social innovation for security, what are the coverages? Social innovation for security of, for security of life, livelihood, social inclusion, eradicating poverty, promotion of eco-sanitization. So last year there was one girl from International Indian Schools, girls, I think, if I remember correctly, this was a very impressive, extensive survey done by this girl, Zainab Khan. I was very much impressed with this girl's work, and I'm sure this year this girl will be able to do something. So the only thing which was lacking in her work was, although it was an amazing, extensive survey done by this girl, Zainab Khan, she did not add something little bit of creative to come up with some solution. So which I'm sure this year she will definitely be able to do, because I found her as very proactive. And then of all the projects which I saw last year, this was the most extensive survey done in the project. So I'm sure this year she will be able to come up with a very good solution, and then also able to work something more, add to this, and then extrapolate her work, whatever she did. And then social innovation for climate change, adaptation, resilience, development, disaster risk reduction, social institutional reframing, promoting social inclusion, responsible consumption and management, etc. So we all are aware of the issues, cultural issues associated with the the caste system in the in India, and then we face a lot of inclusion problem, due to various reasons. There are various such issues related to such social entrepreneurship. So there is a lot of difference between social entrepreneurship and then also the business related entrepreneurship, where social entrepreneurship are the entrepreneurs who do not look at the profit and loss, no accounts related to that. They look at only what can we contribute to the society. So one of them is Give India initiative, which is came up, and then you might have seen a lot of news about that during the COVID-19 thing in the TV. And then crowdfunding. Science India Forum is one among them. We only think about what can we contribute to the students other than the academic activities. And Children's Science Congress is one among them, which is non-academic related. So how can we improve the personality development of, contribute to the personality development of children? Let's also look at the various social issues that we come across in India. They are, one of them is alcohol related, animal welfare and rights, the caste system, child labor, crime, cultural issues, corruption, drought, dowry system, electricity related issues, environmental issues, farmer suicide, gender inequality, and women will definitely be able to think something on this. So gender equality is the main key issue that Zainab Khan also highlighted in her project when she spoke about the menstrual issues and then also the various related issues related to that. Human rights, and then hygiene, mosquitoes and other insects. And most of us do not even know how do mosquitoes contribute to the ecosystem, right? All of us only know that it comes and bites us and then creates havoc with various kinds of diseases. But then mosquitoes also contribute to ecosystem. In fact, recently there is a scientific study which says that the saliva of mosquito has medicinal value. So some scientific study is going on in that. Like cockroaches, we always look at only the issues that cockroaches create, right? But then cockroaches also contribute to the ecosystem by degrading the waste and then make creating nutrient out of it. Like, so there are, in everything there are, so if you just look at every issue, there is a something good that is coming out of this. Even today's orientation, when I'm giving, last year we could not give orientation to the students because going to the schools, which is during our working day, to each school and then giving is a difficulty, right? So we faced some problem problem due to the COVID-19, but then it is a blessing in disguise. Like, we are able to give orientation to students as well. And then also last year, only a few teachers could attend the orientation, but this year, many teachers are able to attend this because it's orient. So there is also something good that is happening because of the COVID-19, right? Religious differences, taboos and stigmas, various associated with this, violence, water scarcity and quality, women's safety, etc. So what should be the focus? So satisfy one or many of the basic needs through social innovation approach. So first understand what is the ecology, economy and society, where does it stand now, and then what are the social needs, and then come up with some social innovation for those social needs. The innovation need not be, as I mentioned, that it should be at least new to the beneficiaries you are targeting. So the problem which you are addressing, it should be new to that, but you can, it may be already applied for addressing some other problems, but it doesn't mean that it should be new to the world. So long as you are addressing, applying it to your surroundings and then giving some solution which will have an impact on the society, that will be considered as a innovation. Social innovation move through 4 I process: idea, intervention, implementation and impact. So you come up with some idea, that is, pick up some problem and then come up with some idea and do an intervention on that, try to ponder about the problem and then come up with some solution or approach, and then implementation. And it should have an impact. Unless it has an impact, it will never become a solution. It will remain only as an idea, right? Otherwise it will not become a creative idea. So let's look at the project ideas for this. So Earth Hour is one of the, so all of us celebrated Earth Hour in March. Every year it comes to the end of March, between 8:30 to 9:30, 1 hour, we all observe by switching off all our lights, right? So the objective is to sensitize and creative awareness among the society at large, realize optimal use of limited resources, save energy, environment, and economy. So the methodology is collect data on energy consumption from 20 households. Need not be 20, you can actually do it from many more houses, and then keep 50% of that as control. Do not change their pattern of energy consumption. Ask the remaining 50% of the household to observe Earth Hour on a daily basis. So normally we do it only in the March end, but then ask them to do it on a daily basis for, so you have now, it is August, so your project is going to be in the in December, so you have 4 months. So you observe it for 4 months on a daily basis by asking them to switch off the lights for 1 hour every day between 8:30 to 9:30, and then after 3-4 months, you compare the energy consumption patterns in both the groups. And then what is the outcome? A small change could lead to big savings of energy and economy, thereby saving the environment. So you're protecting the environment because you're saving from the carbon emission by saving the emission of carbon dioxide to the environment. So with such sensitization, an initiative of creating awareness among other households would take the message far and why. Sorry, again, I'm getting disturbed with this. Okay, so healthy food initiative in school. So what does this talk about? So school canteens normally provide unhealthy junk food, right? And they are, is it possible to replace them with healthy food in a manner that can attract the younger generation? How can we do this? So you can come up with some solutions. So the objective is to understand the difference between healthy and unhealthy food, to identify type of food provided in school canteens, to replace unhealthy food stuff. It's not only in canteen, even in the other public places, like the common places like the railway station or other common places. Even when we have our gatherings, normally packaged foods are given, which are generally junk foods, not the healthy foods. And assess the impact of introducing a change. So what's the methodology? Gather information about the components that make the food healthy and unhealthy. Evaluate, compare the body mass index and also BMR in children from a school. Need not be a school, you can do it also in the other public places. Group them according to their consumption pattern and the healthy versus unhealthy. And then create awareness about healthy nutrients in the food. So nutrients, you don't need to be doing the analysis and then find out what are the nutrients. You can Google and then find out what do these food which you are picking up, the unhealthy and the healthy food, the junk food as well as the healthy food you are picking up, what nutrients do they contain? You can Google and get it. You can also talk to some of the what you call nutritional experts and then get the information from them. But then always ask the source of the information. Depending on local varieties of the cuisine, try replacing the unhealthy food. Record your observation on acceptance of the particular food item, and then convince customers to replace junk food with unhealthy food, with healthy food, and it could bring a revolution in the terms of health. Let's look at the next. So, design, development, modeling, and planning for sustainable living. This is the fourth subthing. So, defining carrying capacity, threshold limits, sustainable production, sustainable consumption, habitat development, transportation system, energy system, pollution monitoring, impact assessment, natural resource management, farming systems, and design, climate change, resilience, adaptation, etc. Let's try to understand this more by going through some of the project ideas. So, in the design, what all things can be done? Design a house for flood-prone area based on the challenges that we saw. We faced some of the states recently faced challenges from flood, right? So, how can we modify the pattern of a house? How can we design a house? So, at this moment, during the COVID situation, you may not be able to make a model, but then you can definitely design something with the help of a drawing and then try to come up with some idea and then you can present it in case that is your interest. And then later on, you can extend it to do some modeling and then try to implement it in the field later. Design a utility-based product from natural waste available in your surroundings. Explore the scientific principles involved in making and the application. Find an interesting element in nature around you, like a leaf, spider, web, bird nest, etc., and understand its scientific principle and possibility and design a product being inspired from it. Understand the current scenario of solid waste management in your locality. I mentioned at the beginning of this, there are two garbage bins kept, green and black, but then is it implemented? No, it's not. So how can we make it happen? Is it possible? First of all, map the planning involved for public transport system in your area in relation to the need. Suggest possible ideas for improvement of the system. Definitely all of us, whether be it in Saudi Arabia or in India, we come across various public transport system related issues, right? So how can we address? Can you give some ideas? And is it possible to implement? So one example which I can talk about here is, in 2007, I moved from Dubai to India after working for about 8 years in India, in Dubai. When I moved to Pune, so I took up a responsibility of setting up a technology center, global technology center, Asia Pacific technology center in India, for one US-based company. So when I was walking every day in the morning, I faced one problem about 200, 300 meters away from my house. So you find that large garbage bins are kept in the cities. And nowadays, it has become much better because after the implementation of this initiative by our Prime Minister Modi, the garbage bins do not exist. They come and collect it. So it used to overflow, and then it used to give stinking smell. So I had two options. One is to ignore it and then take another route and then go for my walking. The other one is it possible to find a solution for this? So I started discussing with my apartment people. There were about 50 apartments, residents in my building. Everybody discouraged me, saying that this will not work in India. Don't think that this is Dubai and all. But then I said, why cannot we do this? So first I Googled and then got the local ward's email, and then I wrote to him. He did not respond. Three times I wrote to him, he did not respond. Then I wrote to the Pune Municipal Commissioner, and then he was a proactive person. He replied to me with the CC to this ward officer. This ward officer took it negatively. He came to my house with a lot of gundas, about 5-6 gundas, and then he came and, did you make a complaint about, are you Dr. Narayan? Did you make a complaint? I said, I have not made a complaint. I'm trying to solve the problem which is existing outside nearby my surroundings. And then he realized that I am a genuine person, and then it turned out to be successful. And then the problem was that they were taking the garbage in the morning, and then it used to overflow by afternoon. And then they started with my request, they started picking it up twice in a day. And not only that, they also started doing the sanitation and the pest control in the area every day, whenever I call. And they also they gave me the phone number. So this is some of the initiatives we can take. That's what I'm saying. So, and then you can convert it into scientifically as a project. So let's look at one of the, sorry to, again, this is disturbing me. So project infectious disease modeling. So this project is about, although medical advances are there, infectious diseases, preventing infections is the first place, first that should be done, right? So understanding the dynamics of disease transmission is essential. So develop a model for prediction, studying the nature of transmission and progression of the disease with time in the society. So how is it done? So collect data on type of disease causing organism, population of size in the area, date of incidence of the disease, and infective and recovered, and then death for at least 6 to 7 consecutive days. This is what is being done in the COVID-19. Period of incubation of the organism, and then description of the SIR model mathematically, which is susceptible, infective, and remove. And then try to plot a graph, and then try to find a pattern out of this, and then come up with some creative ideas to solve the problem. Now let's look at the last but not the least, the sub-theme 5, which is traditional knowledge system for sustainable living. So as I mentioned at the beginning that our ancestors, grandparents used to use a lot of traditional system, but then none of us have tried to understand the scientific reasons behind why we are doing that. And then many of them could definitely can be converted into projects, like one of the students from Assam who was identified as the promising project in the out of the 19. She used the jasmine flower and rose flower and made an extract, and then tried to find out how is it contributing in terms of nutrient, and then also instead of wasting the flowers as in the garbage and then contributing to the environment, you can make use of it as a resource and then contribute to the ecosystem. Ecosystem management, conservation, resource optimization, energy efficiency, system efficiency, promoting growth within and local inclusion. Let's look at some projects out of this. Analysis of traditional food practices in comparison with modern food practices. See, so you can talk to your grandparents and try to come up with some. So depending upon the type of region, there is a lot of variation from South India to North India and East India to West India, right? Then what are the modern food habits, and then what were the old habits, and then try to come up with some analysis, and then find out, try to come up with some creative idea out of this, and then give some solution. So here, so they have studied the comparison of modern and the junk food, the modern food as well as the traditional food, compare the diversity of plant animal products involved in the preparation of the selected food items, study the loss of traditional skills and people due to change of food practices, analysis of nutritional value between the soil. Analysis of nutritional value need not be, you need not do the analysis and find out, you can definitely Google and get, and also talk to the nutrition specialist and then food nutritionist, and then you can ask food technologist also, you can ask to analyze the energy required for the preparation of the selected food items. And this is the methodology. So identify the change in food habits, do a survey with through questionnaire, and then list the food items prominently available over the period of 60 to 80 years with the various benchmarks. List the ingredients to identify the biodiversity that supported the ingredients of each dish. Get the recipes of all the dishes with the specific cooking techniques. Even cooking techniques, you see, the difference in cooking techniques can have an impact on the ecosystem. And also on our health. Qualitative and quantitative analysis of the contents of biodiversity, contents of cooking, health benefits, and perception. So qualitative and quantitative analysis, as I mentioned, if it is possible to do the analysis quantitatively by making use of the labs, it is, we can do it. But then at the present scenario, it may not be possible. So you can get the data by Googling and then talking to people who are specialists in this field. And then understanding, so what's the outcome? Understanding of the trend of food practices with impact on the health benefits, biodiversity aspects, etc. Now let's look at the general aspects. What is the criteria for participating in this? The lower age group should be 10 to 14 years. and upper age group is 14 plus to 17 years, and the project should have maximum two. One will be the project leader and the other one is a team member, and there has to be a mandatory guide. It can be a school teacher or it can be outside the school also. The child scientist who has already presented as a group leader at the national level. National level means in India, last year whoever participated cannot be a group leader in the same age group. So suppose somebody has presented as a group leader last year, like for example, Krishnendu, who got A grade, she was in the junior group, a lower age group. If she is in the upper age group now, she can definitely be a leader in the upper category this year. But they can be a co-worker in the same age group this year. Parents whose child would participate in the National Children's Science Congress in the ensuing year should not hold any portfolio in the organizing committee of the CSC conducted at any level. Let's look at the selection process. So registration. So I will share the already the link has been shared for registration. This registration is for participating. So till now you registered for the orientation. So one more link will be shared to all of you through which you can register to participate. And then report submission. So you have plenty of time till December 10th, so almost about 4 months. You can decide who is your guide, who is your team member, and then ponder about which problem you want to address, and then start working on it. And then screening will be done by Science India Forum with the support of the schools. If the schools have got more than three participants, then definitely screening will have to be done at the school level. So we will definitely support the school to do a screening at the school level. And the winners from schools will compete at the Children's Science Congress, which will be the end of December. So how to do a good project? So form a group, as I said, that choose a guide, select a sub-team, and then choose problem, make a hypothesis, prepare a schedule. How do you want to address your problem, and then find a solution. So either an approach or a problem, a solution is okay. And write a report, also prepare a poster, and then submit the report to Science Day Forum, and then oral presentation. So how to, so what is the scientific process? So how do we, so you have a problem, and then how do you address it scientifically? So first is, do survey. So try to do survey and then find out what all has been done in your, has anybody worked on this problem, and then can you address the problem in a different way? Then also, if you want to do survey to find out from various householders to understand the problem about what they're facing, do a survey and then try to come up with a clear cut definition of your problem. And then, so you're collecting data and then collate data. So collate all those data and then analyze those data, and then interpret your results, and then find solutions. Test in the field, which may not be possible. Of course, there are many, many problems for which you don't need to be doing experiments. You have plenty of problems associated with the social innovation area. Even in the other areas, there are many which do not require experiment to be carried out. And there are many problems for which you can carry out the experiments at home, or you can also tell your parents in India, back in India, if I have a house with a compound, they can do experiments there and then give data. Do record all those data, pictures and videos, wherever possible. And then make conclusions out of this, and then present oral presentation and posters. So this is all about scientific process. Selection criteria, the evaluation criteria is based on, so these are the points on which the criteria evaluation will be done. Originality of your concept and idea and concept. And then the relevance of the project to the sub-team, scientific understanding of the issues, data collection, analysis, experimentation, and then validation, interpretation of the problem and problem solving, teamwork, and then report and presentation, follow-up action. So follow-up action is applicable only if there is a screening at a school level, and then if some feedback is given during the oral presentation, those have to be incorporated when you come to the next level. So have you done a follow-up on that, and then have you implemented them? Improvement also. From the previous one. What else? The project report should include detailed description of the work done, incorporate evaluator suggestions at the previous level, maintain a logbook and get it signed by your guide. So So last year it was mandatory to sign physically, but this year you can just get an email from your guide as a that there is a concurrence between the student and the guide. Posters are mandatory, so for posters we will have a separate session for the posters, because during the oral presentation only the students and the guide will be able to participate, and during the poster presentation we can make it public and then everybody can participate in the thing, and so that all the parents and teachers and the students, everybody can see what others have done. This is the template for report writing, so cover cover page, title of the project name, and of the leader and the member, name and address of the guide, abstract, which is not more than 300 words, why this project, so write the importance of the project, and then give previous studies if anything is there, table of contents, and then introduction, originality of idea and concept, relevance of the project theme, hypothesis, experiments validation, data collection, analysis of data, interpretation and problem solving, conclusions, and then acknowledge whoever supported it. So for the lower age group, the maximum number of words should be 2,500 words, so do not exceed 2,500 words, and for seniors it is 3,500 words. Mention all the references because it adds value. Oral presentation is 8 minutes, so when you practice for oral presentation, do not exceed 8 minutes, and then question answer session is 2 minutes, but then if the children if the evaluators, the judges need more time, they might ask take more time. Leader and member has to do presentation. At the national level, only the leader is allowed to present, but then here we would like to give the opportunity for the leader as well as the member, so that both get experience out of this what you call the event. Display the exercise. Display of models, chart should be arranged for judgment if required. So though it is going to be an online event, still you can present your models and then speak. Posters must be prepared, so these are relevant when you do the national. So here, since you're going to be presenting as online, the size is not going to be so important, because they will not be physically seeing them. But if you can make a poster of the size given, it will definitely be able to, because then you'll also comply with this. So the contents of this poster are as given, so I will be sharing this by email, this presentation, so you will be able to go through. So few guidelines, the parents and guides. The project is to be done by children, so allow them to think on their own, and then you only give guidance to them and not to do the project on them. So do not try to impose something on them, because allow them to think, because most often children come up with more creative ideas than us. Therefore, allow them to think and then prompt them to come up with ideas, and then you can give your suggestions. Pick up simple problems, as I said, which we face every day. Keep the projects at the student's level, so do not go to the level which is above the student's level, because that will definitely have an impact on the evaluation. So the judges will give lesser marks if it's not simple. So the four pillars you remember: simple, practical, inexpensive, and then also implementable. The main objective of this exercise is to encourage the children to think and come up with creative ideas. So there is an official website. If you want to get more details, you can go through this website and then find. And question answer session, there were two questions which came to me. What is scientific method, which I have already explained. So there is a scientific method. So try to go through the typical scientific method, which was explain the one of the slides. The other question is, can I use the example problems given in the activity guide and then give a different solution? Of course, definitely you can give. You can pick up the same problem. If you feel that you can come up with some better solution, you can definitely give that. So with that, I'll stop my presentation.